Well, in this video here, been working a lot of horses. We've been really busy and we are getting a little bit behind on weekly videos. I have a lot of horses in. We've got a lot of footage filmed. Now we're just trying to get everything done. Put together some more videos. Right here, I'm riding Hanson, and notice how I had to get after him. Now, the reason why I started getting on his mouth a little bit there, and I'm going back and I'm going to reposition myself, is as I started to approach that Cavalletti, he wanted to speed up. Now, this is a very normal reaction. All horses see the Cavalletti, and the first thing they want to do is accelerate and get over it faster. And that actually goes against everything the Cavalletti is all about. Cavalletti is about timing and footfall. Now here, this is why Hanson's in for training. The tarp. Now this horse will do anything for you and be willing to do it, except when it comes to crossing a tarp. He's had a few people try him out, try to get him over it. They were unsuccessful. Now, I got him going over the tarp on the ground, worked him in the round pen. Now I got him over the tarp riding. It just takes time and it takes consistency. And I think that is one thing that we need as riders, as horsemen, we need to focus on is being very consistent in how we handle these horses. It's no different raising our kids. We have to be consistent in how we love on them, how we reprimand them. We have to be consistent on how we tell them they're doing a good job every day. It's the same with a horse. He has to know the distinction between right and wrong, but he has to be showed what is right and wrong. So when they make a mistake, let them make a mistake. I see so many riders and handlers out there try to avoid a mistake. We don't learn by doing right all the time. We learn by what we do wrong. That's what makes us stronger. That's what makes us smarter. So let them commit to the mistake, then correct them. Now here what I'm doing is I worked him on the rail there. And now I'm just kind of loping him off. I'm freeing him up. I'm making him work. I'm making him think about something else. And I'm doing it all on a loose rein. I don't have him all drove up into the bit. Now this is Buck. Now Buck is a typical horse that has not had a whole lot done with him. He's getting a little age on him, and what has happened is, I don't know how many owners he's had, might have only been one, two, maybe three or ten, but he's finally starting to show me what he's all about. And with Buck, we have some good days, and then we have some not so good days. Now, I start out every session working him on the ground, and this horse does really well on the ground. You notice I had the rope on his hind end there. I've had it up under his tail, and he does really good on the ground. The difference is when I get in the saddle, he starts having issues. He's fearful of the ropes by his eye. All of a sudden, he doesn't like the ropes touching him when you're on him. And I don't know his history, but I would say that maybe he was originally taught old school. A lot of times the old cowboy hands would use the rope, not just to rope animals, but they'd use it as a reprimand tool on the horse. They'd take the coils and slap them alongside the head once in a while to get them to turn their shoulders, lift their shoulders. They use the loop or the tail of the rope to spank them, and don't get me wrong, you know, I've done that myself, but that's kind of the last resort. Now right here, I just roped Smarty and he shot to the left big time. And so I kick him back up. Chris took the rope off of Smarty, and I go right back to doing the scary thing. This is called consistency. You cannot teach him anything if they get fearful of it. Now, I want him to position up better. And right now, his whole mind is thinking, wait a minute, that rope went by my eye. That rope roped that green thing. It makes a lot of noise when the rope hits it. I'm getting scared. So I bring him back up to it. And he's standing there, not out of willingness. He's standing there because I'm telling him to. Now, I start slapping it, and I slap it. Notice the head bobs up and down with the rope. All of this is very cultish-type signs. Now, I want him to parallel that dummy again, and he's not wanting to move to my right. So what I do is I'm tired of trying to jerk on him a little bit there, and I'm tired of kicking. So you got to think a little bit. Well, if he's afraid to go to the right because the rope's on the right side, then move the rope on the left side and he'll go right. And then right there, just relax. I'm giving him his reins again. As I build up my rope, put it coils in my left hand, and I go back to snapping it again, because that's the whole point of this right now, getting him used to that noise. Now here, I'm on Max again. I'm working with Max, and Max is very fearful of ropes on his hind end. Anything on his hind end. Now, there's a couple things going on here. I don't know how he was treated when he was younger, at say a year or 2 years old. He's 5 years old. So he's still colt. He's still young in the mind. But what I have to do with Max is I have to take him back to the very basics quite a bit and get him going in circles on the ground, getting that rope around his hind end. Now here, I'm swinging my rope on him, but I don't want to immediately go to swinging a rope off of this horse when he's deathly afraid of a rope touching him. What if my customer's on him? He's 60 plus years old. He doesn't ride every day. He doesn't set a saddle like I do. What if he was to get that rope accidentally back behind his butt there and see how I'm playing with it, snapping it over his tail head there? What if he was to do that and this horse went to humping like that? Somebody would get hurt. So now what I'm doing is I'm working him, moving his feet, but I'm also swinging the rope. Now there's a secret here. When you move their feet, and you do it when they're a little more tired, he has to find his balance, he has to find his rhythm. So I'm giving him that job to do. Then all of a sudden I start swinging that rope. That gives him something else to think about. But he's having to think about moving his feet first. So then the rope doesn't become such a scary object. Now what I'm doing here is I'm just loping him out. We've been walking, we've been trotting. It's time to move his feet faster. Get his mind thinking about going a little faster, gaining a little more speed. Now as we go along here, I'll actually start swinging that rope. Your horses will get used to you swinging that rope at a walk. If all you do is walk, it'll be no problem. But this is going to be a heel horse. So we got to be able to swing this rope at a full run coming out of a box. So after he gets comfortable with the rope swinging at a walk and then a trot, we lope him and we start swinging the rope again. That's just the process. You don't want to jerk a loop out, kick him into a lope or a run and start swinging the rope off of him. That don't teach him anything, except I got to be scared of the rope. And guys, you can always steal a ride or two on them by swinging a rope. You just can. Now this is Shiloh. And we're in the last week of Shiloh's training. and she's really finally starting to fall into the program. It's been a while for her. It's been kind of a tough road for her. She's 9 years old. She's only had one owner. That owner is not a real experienced horseman. So she's kind of developed her own program, if you will, and it's not exactly the same program as what I do. But I'm real proud of this mare. We've had our battles, no doubt, but she's really starting to soften up and listen. Now right here, this was the first time we've been outside and getting ready to go over this water obstacle. Again, it's white plastic, most dreaded thing ever. Now it's filled full of water. But what I do like here is she's trying to do what I'm asking her to do. She's not shooting backwards 100 miles an hour. She's not shooting off to the left and right. And see, I relax on her and I reward her. Now I grab the reins and I push her with my legs. I hold her snug with my legs. I tell people it's kind of like grabbing the toothpaste tube. When you go to squeeze it, you squeeze it pretty firm and you shoot the toothpaste out. It's the same with this horse. If I hold her with my legs firm, eventually she's just going to shoot forward. So we dance here a little bit. This is very typical, but I'm just looking for that right there. 1 foot at a time. Sometimes you'll only get 1 foot in for a while. Other horses, they'll just step right in it and move on through. They don't have a care in the world. This mare here, she thinks about everything. So what she's doing here is very typical. She's kind of rooting her nose in it, trying to take a drink. She's realizing that it's not going to kill her, that it is just simply water. So I squeeze her a little bit more. Now we step in. Now notice her hind feet are out and her front feet were in. Now, a lot of people would quit right there. I won't. The object is for her to walk into the middle of that pool, stand, and then walk on out. There we go. I reward her. I flex her. See that? I'm always flexing my horses. I teach them to flex so that then they learn to relax. That's my relax cue. So now she's just standing in there. And she's calm. She's not challenging me. Reins are totally draped loose on her neck. She did really good. I'm proud of her. Now here I'm just going up and down the bank. You guys have seen that bank in previous videos. Starts out at nothing, goes up to where it's 6 foot tall. She's not ready for me to bail off on the real steep part yet, but she is getting her feet under her enough to come off of like the 3 foot section. Now here I'm getting real ready for the Smarty, and notice I've got the old Dunny horse there, Max, tied up to the fence. The reason is these guys have got to get used to being tied. There are going to be rope horses, so he needs to be tied for hours at a time. Doesn't kill him. He needs to also get used to that Smarty Steer and the four-wheeler running around, because he's going to start seeing that thing quite often. That's part of the training program. So he's over there tied while I'm working Rio. Now, Rio, I can't say enough good things about this horse. This horse here is a really, really good horse. He can most definitely be another Roni. It just, what he needs is he just needs a lot of consistent handling and training. What I've got here is I got my GoPro cam on, kind of killing two birds at one stone, taking a camera angle of GoPro and the camera angle of TJ. We're putting it all together. We're roping Smarty. And I am still in just my snaffle bit Makati rein setup. Now, a lot of guys would be saying, well, you should be putting a tie down on him and you could be putting him in a shank bit by now. Yes, I could. But I don't believe in using mechanical devices to get my horse's head down and carried like that. It would be a faster way to train, but I don't train that way. I believe that my hands and my feet can eventually get that horse to lower his head down where he finds natural balance on his own. And I again tell everybody, I can rope off of all of my horses in a snaffle bit. So when I do a lot of smarty work with my horses, green horses or totally broke horses, I'll put him back in the snaffle. And he's coming along really well. He's starting to find that little wider position that I like to head from, that everybody should be heading from nowadays. He's naturally starting to rate better. He's listening to my legs. This horse is going to be doing some pretty neat stuff here in the next few weeks. I'm real proud of this horse. He's going to do really well. He's going to be the kind of horse that you can do anything on, not just rope. Look how he scores. He does really good. I notice when he comes out, he's starting to come off my hand finally, not my legs. Headers, your horses come out of the box with your hand, not your feet. Comes up, stays right in that rate position I want him. Crack a knot on him. Now I'm slapping it there, getting him used to that rope a little more. Well, guys, you take care and you ride safe.